teachers. I'm really happy to see you all. And today I will present my project work. The purpose of my project work was at the start to build a lesson on geographical discoveries in 15th century. But scaffolding, it became an entire module. Why I chose this topic? I thought a lot about what kind of topic I would have choose, and I chose this one because it has a lot of links with other subjects. So it is suitable to an interdisciplinary approach, and it allows to reflect on the difference and the similitudes between several cultures as a resource, favoring the development of citizenship and constitution skills that we know are really important in the school nowadays. I established a structure for my project work, and that is divided into parts. The first one is an historical part, and the second one is a geographical part. The first is about the age of discovery and the Columbus experience. The second is about the winds, and in particular the trade winds that helped Columbus to reach America. As I said before, I will present four lessons. The age of my learners is 16, 17. They are the students of the linguistic lyceum, and the level of the learners is, the language level of the learner is a B1 upper. The subject probably is pre-taught in L1 because you know they study Columbus, the discovery of America during primary and first secondary school. At the end of the module, I want that my students know the age of discovery, as I said before, the history of Christopher Columbus, and the winds that he used to travel from Spain to the Caribbean and to come back. The skills I want they arrive to are both language skills and content skills. Language skills will be the conscious use of some expressions and words, and content skills will be the development of open-minded respect to ethnic and cultural diversity, and the ability to recognize some phenomena that I wrote on my project work, but I didn't write here because it's too long. As you can see in the excerpt one, I established also some sentences that I would love to hear to my students at the end of the module. This is what I want that they know at the end of the module. So I decided to divide the lesson in three main parts, phases, a learning one, a consolidation one, an evaluation one, and for the first and the fourth lesson there is also a warm-up to recall to memory what the students, the students studied before. So we can go to the lessons. The first one is about the age of discovery, and as I said, the first exercise is an exercise of warm-up. They have to, is a jigsaw, they have to complete the sentences matching the first part on the left side with the second on the right, and then they have to rewrite the test in another space. In this case, the focus is on the content, and the content terminology is implicit. they are repeating what they have already done, and most of all, at the end of the exercise, they have to rewrite it, and the rewriting of the text is important because it is a strategy that is called haptics, no? In which they have to memorize, in this case to rememorize, what they have learned. Then I go to the learning phase, here is a clause in which I present the age of discovery, and they have to use the words in the list to complete the sentence. In this case, the focus is on content and on language, sorry, implicitly they are learning the content terminology. As you can see, the content terminology is the one here. I didn't choose the words of the content terminology because I established to use them with the definition in a crossword in which they can consolidate their learning. The last exercise of the first lesson is an exercise of evaluation in which they had to correct some content errors, content mistakes. The second lesson is dedicated to Columbus experience. I decided to start from some visual imageries to let the students know the vocabulary that they will use, reuse in the exercise 2 of consolidation, in which they have, forgot to say that each exercise of lesson 1 and also lesson 2 and the others will be studied alone before will be done alone, and then will be correct with other with in pairs or in group. So that they can lower the emotional filter and ensure to a better learning. This is another exercise of consolidation. We use the words they have found in the exercise before to a role play. This guided, it is also all guided, because in the learning phase we have a video that I don't know if it's possible to see. I'll try to show it. Okay, no matter. Dove?
A destra.
Qui? Questa?
No, no, quella che avevi preso.
Questa? Okay. Okay. In the video, the students will find the word they have already studied in the first part of the lesson. And here there are two exercises. The video is about the story of Christopher Columbus. And the first part is another clause in which they have to complete, listen to the recording, they have to complete the sentences, The second one is another exercise in which they have some questions and they have to answer. Obviously, there is a progression between the first and the second exercise, and it is an opportunity to listen to the recording two or three times, I don't know, to memorize the content. At the end, I have an exercise of evaluation that is a sort of ID card of Christopher Columbus, in which they have to rewrite what they have learned and to memorize once more. Lessons 3 and 4 will be on wins, because I choose why I choose this this topic, because wins were very important to Columbus to reach America. But in the first, before introducing the global wind patterns and the trade wind, it's important to recall to memory what are winds and what are their characteristics. So here there is a warm-up exercise in which the students have to complete the sentences with the words given in the grid. And then I thought about the learning phase, presenting to the students an experiment. Because the content, I am trying to explain to the students the Coriolis effect. Because the content is really hard, in this case the language will be light. And we have some exercises in which they are guided to the experiment, and I thought about another one rewriting exercise. In which they have to write the procedure following the sentences so that they can understand what is the process they are doing to arrive to a solution. At the end, there is a sort of consolidation exercise in which they have to answer to some question there that are almost yes that that will be sorry, I don't remember a word. Okay, I will say it in Italian. Can I? Okay. Prevedono in English is foresee. That foresee only, almost only, yes and no answers. To understand, to verify if the students have understood the process, I posed here an exercise, an evaluation exercise, in which they have to determine which phenomena are caused by the Coriolis effect. So I think that this is a really thinking-based exercise. They have to think about what it is connected with Coriolis effect and what not. Now the guys will be ready to study global wind patterns, and in the first exercise they have to reorder the text, and then and the content of this text will be discussed one more time in the exercise 1B, in which they have to read the sentences, underline the mistakes, and then write the correct work on the right side of the grid. And at the end, they have to check one more time with their partner. The evaluation exercise is a drawing exercise. It's more or less the same of that of Trade Winds, but in this case they have only to draw the wind. At the end of the section of Trade Winds that is opened with a crossword, probably you can see the definition. You cannot see the definition. I don't have one. The last exercise, as I said, is in the last exercise they have to answer to the questions, to draw the winds, to name the winds, and to check the answer by doing an internet search. I decided to propose to my students as final assessment a project work in which they will work in pair, and they will have to imagine to write a brochure to celebrate Columbus Day in American schools. So they will divide the text in paragraphs, and I don't remember here. Sorry. Okay. So that they can and they will choose the things that they think are most important in their learning here there are the solutions of the exercises. The sitography and the bibliography. And thank you. Sorry for my English.
Devo andare via perché qualcuno di voi sa che devo partire. Ci rivediamo, spero, quando rientro. Organizziamo una pizza, qualcosa.
Bravo, sì.
Ciao.
Grazie.
Grazie.
Hello everybody, I am Ofelia Leone and I worked with Elisabetta Scicchitano. Our project work is on atoms and elements. Well, this is our first experience as a CLIL teacher and the first time that we designed material for the CLIL lesson. So before to show you our work, I just quickly show how we reached this aim. And we always keep in mind that a successful CLIL lesson is based on 4C: content, communication, cognition, and culture. And we also know that CLIL education is based on some important basic. First of all, that is learner-centered. And we have to forget that teaching based on a teaching-centered lesson. And the role of the student is a central one, so the students, learners, we have to keep them always active and interactive. And another important point of CLIL education is working in group, because cooperative learning is very effective. And also in CLIL we have to use a variety of teaching techniques and many different material, because never forget that learners' attention lasts 10 minutes. So avoid to get bored our learner. And another important thing is the dual role of teaching language and content, because in CLIL education we have to focus on language but not sacrifice the content. So keeping in mind all those things, how we designed our material. First of all, we choose the topic. So define the topic is important, because designing CLIL material takes time. So we choose a general topic, always usable, something that we can teach in almost all the schools, and something that all the student has to know. And that's why we choose atom and element. Then we focused on the content learning objective, that is what we want our student to know. So we wrote some sentences with the core concept, and at the end of the lesson we expect from our student they know that concept. Then we deconstructed the macro CLIL in 4 micro content learning objective, and this is another typical technique of a CLIL lesson scaffolding, breaking down a task in many steps, so that student accumulating knowledge step by step, the student can reach the final aim. We don't forget that to provide the learners with the language, because students are learning new contents in a foreign language. So they have a new language that is the subject language, and maybe they are not so good in English language. We implemented assessment of learning for learning, because assessment is not only of learning to see if students are following, if they are learning, but also for learning. So for this it's very important the working in group. And of course, we included activity for all four language ability. So this is our lesson plan. The age of learners is 16, 17 years, and the students are scientific and classic lyceum. The English level is supposed to be B1. The macro CLIL is atom and elements, and the student must know the core concept present in 2 excerpts we wrote. And prerequisite is only the matter. They have to know just the physical properties and the physical chains of the matters, the matter. We designed activity for each microclaw, and we started with a warm up. It's an activity just to introducing the lesson, and we asked students to play a game just to decrease the affective filters to warm the atmosphere. The first activity, the first microclaw, is the atomic structure, and we designed 5 activities. And these activities include a learning phase, consolidation phase, and assessment phase. The second microclaw is the atomic and the mass numbers, the full chemical symbol for an element. And even in this microclaw, we designed 5 different activities with the learning, consolidation, and assessment phase. The same for microclaw 3, that is just an introduction to the periodic table, that is the next topic. We want just to introduce the student and the name of the elements. And there are 5 activities also for this microclaw: a learning, a consolidation, and assessment phases. And finally, there is a final assessment, the microclaw 4. So the warm-up is a game. We ask the student to play a guessing game to guess the topic of the lesson. So we say, look at the blackboard and answer the question, which word do you know? What do you think the lesson will be about? And this is the pick, these are the word. Maybe they know something, or they don't know other word, but they can guess, they can try to guess the topic of the lesson. The first microclaw is the atomic structure. Exercise 1 is a learning phase. We want to give the student the language, we want to give the student the content. So they ask them to match the phrases and formulate 5 sentences about the atom. This exercise is a visual one, a visual activity, because the brain likes pictures, likes visual. So they can consolidate the knowledge they already know from the exercise 1. Exercise 3 is complete the sentences using the information you already have. So this is in the main time a consolidation phase, but also an assessment phase, because the teacher can know if student know, and if there is a student, if there are some students that don't know, the group can help, because they discuss in group, they agree, they compare, and so everybody can learn. Exercise 4 and 5 are assessment phase, and the first one, exercise 4, is we focused on the content, and exercise 5 we focused on both content and language. So we ask to choose the correct word and then put the sentences in order to form a well-written paragraph. Microclaw 2, Elisabetta, tell you.
So this is microclaw 2, and we are going to introduce the atomic and the mass numbers and the full chemical symbol for an element. This is exercise 6. It's a learning phase, because they have a list of 6 words, and they have to complete the sentences comparing 2 images. So it's something that include thinking, something they have to think to. Exercise 7 is both a learning phase and a consolidation phase. it is a learning phase because in the cloud you can find a definition of the chemical symbol. And in the other image is a completion. You have to put the name in this blank using atomic number or mass number. Exercise 8 is an assessment. They have to if they understood what the atomic number and the mass number are, they will be able to write the right number over below this. Exercise 9 is important for us because it is an haptics. It involves a writing exercise. It is a writing exercise. They know the previous image. Okay. They had to look to these two images and then to write the answer to the question, always comparing the two images. There is an extra answer that they don't need to use. Exercise 10 is it focuses on language because they have to choose between two kind of words. And is not only focused on language, but even on content, because there is protons and neutrons as a word. The microclaw 3 is an introduction to the periodic table, and they have to suppose a question reading a text in which there are only the answer. So this is the text about the periodic table. Okay. And on the right you can see the answer, and on the left there are the right questions they have to write. Here we see. Okay. This is a song about the element. We want them to know the names of some element. So we choose this word, which is a video too, because they need to see how the name of the elements are written. So this is only an example. Just.
Balloons are full of helium, and so is every star. Stars are mostly hydrogen, which may someday fill your car. Iron is a metal, you see it every day. Oxygen eventually will make it rust away. Carbon in its ordinary form is coal. Crush it together and diamonds are born. Come on, come on, meet the elements. May I introduce you to our friends, the elements. Like a box of paints that are mixed to make every shade. They either combine to make a chemical compound.
It's only an example to show you that the names of the element are linked to the symbol, the chemical symbol of the element. So they first to listen to this song, and then using the text. Okay. This is the text of the song. We highlighted the name of some elements with different colors, And then they have, after listening to the song for three times, they have to be able to write the words that are missing. Okay. This is all the song. Exercise 13 is based always on the song, because they have to read the text and try to find four verbs in the text which specify a characteristic of the element. Because in the song there is, for example, iron is to rust away, oxygen make iron rust away. So we give them the synonyms with their definition, and they have to find these verbs in the song, so they can learn something about language, a synonym. Then we will give our students another song about the periodic table. It is similar to the first, but it shows the periodic table and how the elements are.
And now, ASAP Science presents the elements of the periodic table.
There's hydrogen and helium, then lithium, beryllium, boron, carbon everywhere, nitrogen all through the air, oxygen so you can breathe, and fluorine for your pretty teeth, neon to light up the signs, sodium for salty times,
magnesium,
aluminium, silicon,
phosphorus,
then sulfur, chlorine, then argon,
potassium,
and calcium so you'll grow strong,
scandium,
titanium, vanadium, and chromium, and manganese.
This is periodic table, noble gases stable, halogens and alkali reactive recipe. Each period will see new outer shell electrons are added, moving to the right.
Okay, this is always the example. Because in the next exercise, we want our students working in groups to play this game. That is. Okay, they have 15 minutes to write the names of the element, and the game is we need to see it because I don't know. Okay, this is. If you don't write the right word of the right name of the elements, the game continues to go on. But if the name is not right, it doesn't go on. You cannot. I'm sorry. Ah, okay. Oh, here's the thing. Okay, this is the periodic table. Okay. For example, if I write oxygen, automatically the oxygen goes to its place in the periodic table. If I write carbon, it is the same, but if I write fluorine, it's not right, so fluorine doesn't reach right. But if I add an E, fluorine is here. So they have 15 minutes to play this game. In groups, yes. This is a general assessment of on the names of the element. And then we have the final assessment, microcode 4. They have to solve a crossword with all the new words they have already learned. These are except 1 and 2 that are the sentences we choose, and they are what we what our students have to know at the end of this lesson. Something we introduce, something about Dmitry Mendeleev, who was the chemistry professor who published the first periodic table. And because we have the time to to show Teresa our work, we use one colleague.
Where is Teresa? Teresa. Another one.
Teresa? Hello? Okay, she doesn't want to. Thank you for your revision. We find it very useful. Okay, this was exercise 3. We have to complete the sentences, but Teresa told us that it was not very simple. So we change it in this one. For example, the word surrounding was not in any of our exercise. So we substituted it with arranged around that we have had used. Then we introduce neutrons, while before we haven't mentioned it, but they have never found neutral. So they cannot write neutrons if they didn't know neutral. So we write neutrons. This is a learning phase. So now they will learn that neutrons are neutral. Then the other change was charge, that there are two charge 1 and charge 2. The first we have, we put away the first charge and we want them to write the second, but we found that it was better to give them this word before and then ask them to write it. And okay, this is one for us.
Talk together,
okay.
Because we are prepared to make this activity together, so we can change the rule from time to time.
Good evening to all the colleagues and teachers, and we start with our unit
clear the unit. We have chosen a big topic concerning our subject, history of art. And so we have chosen to introduce Ville Savoie, made by Le Corbusier. We have thinking our students, our learners, who study the last year at high school, artistic and scientific school. And so we have chosen also this title, Architecture is Learned Through Game, by using CLIL, because a very important statement written by Le Corbusier was architecture is learned through game, correct and magnificent of form assembled in the light. So before starting our unit, we have focused concerning some point very crucial. So outcomes, age learners naturally, you can change.
Okay.
No, lei. So we can think. We have thought, sorry.
Do you want to declare? She wants to declare okay. The goal of art activity. Yeah.
The goal activity, thinking learners, age our learners, so also content, use language, English level B1, prerequisite knowledge, so learners who know reading plans, perspective and section about architecture, and knowledge concerning readings and identify style, historical style architecture. So we have taught learning outcomes. Two sentences that we love our students say. And so this, Ville Savoie as a manifesto of modern architecture, five points. Written by Le Corbusier that focus this innovation, his innovation in architecture. So we start with a game. We thought this as a jolly game, yeah, because actually it could be put in the end of this activity or
as homework.
As a homework. Yeah. But I have thought to start with this game, enjoyable game, in order to relax our students, to attract their attention, and so
and to let them in a familiar situation,
okay,
in a relaxing.
So after this game, learners can start some steps. We have introduced a set of steps, thinking that learners have to know, to learn new content, so unit content has to be comprehensible, and also language is as to comprehensible, and so we have put in our exercise some steps introducing scaffolding and assessment moment in order to check to if our learners the process of learning or learning. So in this exercise, first exercise, our learner can look carefully two pictures. Visual
teacher, we